The season of Lent is a season of grace for the church because it is this time that we take more seriously our being Christians. That means our being baptized. And in baptism, we share in the suffering and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And this is the essence of Christian life, following the Lord Jesus, making His life our own. Jesus is the good news, and we become the good news the more we are able to follow Jesus Christ. And to follow Jesus means to do His teachings and to practice His teachings in our lives, and especially to join in His death and resurrection, which is what is called the Paschal Mystery. So the high point of Lent, therefore, is the so-called Easter Vigil. This is what happens in Holy Saturday evening. Now, Easter Vigil could be celebrated between 6 o'clock in the evening of Saturday, when darkness comes, up to the dawn of Sunday. The high point of this celebration of the Easter Vigil is our Easter Vigil Mass, which has four parts. The first part is the celebration of the light. That's why it is done when there is already darkness. In this celebration of light, we proclaim that Jesus is the light of the world. In the midst of darkness, then there is the Paschal candle that is lit. And from the Paschal candle, which symbolizes the Lord Jesus, we all get our light. And the whole dark church is being lightened by the candles that the faithful bring together. And then we exalt the Lord, the singing of the exalted. We praise the Lord for the light that is the Lord Jesus Christ. After the celebration of light, then we have the celebration of the Word of God. It is a long time of reading and reflecting over the Word of God. There are 9 readings during this time with the corresponding responsorial psalm or psalms or response of the faithful. And here we follow salvation history from the time of creation up to the time of the resurrection. So, it's a time of reflection, prolonged reflection and hearing of the Word of God. After this, we have the celebration of our baptism. In churches where there are persons to be baptized, especially adults to be baptized, then there is the celebration of their baptism. Now, in many churches, especially in the Philippines, where almost all who participate are already baptized, then there is the renewal of our baptism. The baptismal water is blessed, and then the people renew their baptismal promises, and then they are sprinkled with the holy water, reminding them of their lives of participation in the life of Jesus. And finally, there is a celebration of the Eucharist, that we are happy and we thank the Lord for this gift of the resurrection, which is also a gift of new life to us. In many parishes, this Easter Vigil celebration, which could last from 2 to 3 hours, is immediately followed by the celebration of the Salubong. In the Salubong, the men and the women make procession from different parts of the town or of the parish. And then they come together, the women following the statue of Our Lady of Sorrows, and the men following the statue of the resurrected Christ. And they meet in a particular place where there are angels who would witness the meeting of Our Lady and her son. And then the children would take out the veil of sorrow of the Blessed Virgin, symbolizing the first meeting of the resurrected Jesus with her mother. And then after some singing and prayers, the two groups would move together towards the church in joy. Now that the resurrection is announced to us. In many churches, the salubong follows immediately the Easter Vigil, whereas in other churches, the salubong is celebrated differently at a later time of the dawn. So at about 4 or 3 o'clock, then again, the men and the women would gather in different places and make that procession and of the salubong. So there are various ways of celebrating this. And after the salubong, then they all move to the church and celebrate the Easter Sunday Mass. So this rich celebration would just tell us the importance of the event that we would be celebrating. Easter is the greatest feast in the life of the church. Sad to say, however, although the feast is very meaningful, it is not yet as popular in the Philippines as, for example, the Feast of Christmas, and not even as a celebration of the Good Fridays. There are more people coming together for the Christmas Midnight Mass than people who would come for the Easter Vigil. And even there are more people who would be visiting the church during Good Friday than coming to church during Easter Sunday. It's sad that we have not yet appreciated and we have not yet valued the greatest feast in the church, which is supposed to be the life of every Christian, a process of dying and rising up to Christ. And after Easter Sunday, then we have many weeks more, 50 days more of celebration of Easter, called the Easter time, that we can deepen our own reflection over the resurrection, over the joy of salvation that the Lord Jesus gives us. Remember that Christian life is a life of joy because it is a life of triumph over sin. Yes, we suffer because of the struggle with sin, and that is shown by Lent, that is shown by Good Friday. But our suffering is not the last word. The last word is the joy of the power of the resurrection, which is highlighted during Easter Vigil and Easter Sunday and continues to be celebrated and appreciated during the 50 days of the Easter season, culminating with the coming of the Holy Spirit on Pentecost Sunday.